Hello everyone, this is the first module of Lightning Aura component development. In this module, we will discuss about introduction to Lightning component framework. So the topics which will be covered, that is, what is Salesforce Lightning, why to use Aura components programming model, Aura components, events, browser support for Aura components, my domain, and developer console. So let's first discuss about what is Salesforce Lightning. So Lightning basically includes Lightning component framework. So nowadays, if you are working on Salesforce, so Salesforce provides Lightning experience by default, and in that Lightning experience, you need to use Lightning components. So earlier to Lightning, Salesforce used a classic. So nowadays, if you are working in Lightning experience, so whatever component you will be building, so those are known as Lightning components, and they are developed with the help of Lightning component framework. So advantage of Lightning component is, like, one can build responsive applications for any device. Lightning improves app performance. One can develop components, those can be reused by other developers and admins for communities, Lightning experience, and Salesforce mobile application, right? So if you are developing any Lightning component using Lightning component framework, so those components can be placed on communities, which are nowadays known as sites, then on Lightning experience, or if you are using Salesforce mobile app, so there also you can place your Lightning components. Lightning app builder empowers admins to build Lightning pages visually, without using codes, but you need to make Lightning components available in the Lightning app builder. So if you are creating any home page, app page, or record page with the help of Lightning app builder, so there you just need to drag and drop the components. But if you want to drag and drop any Lightning component, then you need to first build that Lightning component with the help of Lightning component framework. Then only it will be available to place that Lightning component on app page, home page, or record page. So this is basic about what is Salesforce Lightning. Now, why use Aura components programming model? So basically, if we are talking about Salesforce Lightning component framework, so it provides you two framework. One is Aura and one is LWC. It is Lightning web component. So initially we will see all the modules related to Aura, and then later on you will see how we can build components in web components as well. So focusing on the Aura component programming model, so out of the box components, they support event driven architecture, a framework optimized for performance, rich component ecosystem, fast development, device aware, and cross browser compatibility. So these are some features which are available if you are implementing any component with the help of Aura component programming model. So talking about particularly Aura components, so they are self-contained and reusable units of apps. Framework includes a set of pre-built components. Components that come with Lightning design system styling are available in Lightning namespace. So if you are implementing Aura components, so you can use Lightning design system as well, so that you can apply predefined styling and you can modify that as per your requirement as well. You can combine or configure components to form new components in app. A component can contain other components as well as HTML, CSS, JavaScript, or any other web-enabled code, right? So this you need to remember while working with Aura components. So if you are implementing Aura components, so you must know information, or maybe I can say how to code in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript along with Apex, right? So if you are in a Salesforce ecosystem, so everybody is familiar, if they are working as a developer, so they are familiar with Apex. But if you are building any Aura component, so you must be aware with HTML, CSS, and CSS and JavaScript, because all the front end work is done in these three with these three tools only. And if you want to access your S objects, so for that purpose we use Apex, right? So HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and Apex, these four work all together to make any Aura component so that we can interact with the objects and we can provide fast access in the browser. Now, after understanding a little bit about Aura and Lightning Component Framework, so let's compare Lightning and Visual Force. So if we talk about Salesforce Classic, so in Salesforce Classic, we used to develop Visual Force pages. But if you are working in Lightning Experience, so we basically implement Lightning components either through Aura or through web components. So if we compare Lightning and Visual Force, so Lightning provides client-side UI generation, whereas Visual Force supports server-side UI generation. So this VF page basically resides in server, and whenever you hit any button or you perform any event or any activity, so the whole page renders on the UI from the server. But in case of Lightning, you can split it into client and server. So some business logic runs on client side only. It renders only once and it executes client side on client side again and again with the help of JavaScript. But if you want to interact with your S object, in that case, we need to interact with the server, right? So this is the basic difference between Lightning and Visual Force. So Visual Force is totally server-side UI generation, whereas Lightning is client-side UI generation along with server-side access for interacting with S objects. Then Lightning is API-centric model, whereas Visual Force is page-centric model. Lightning supports component-based framework, whereas Visual Force supports MVC framework, that is model, view, and controller. Then in Lightning, JavaScript framework is also supported, whereas in Visual Force, basically tag-based languages are supported. Then Lightning is designed for Lightning experience as well as for Salesforce mobile app. And even Lightning components you can use in Salesforce sites. Those are also known as communities. And if you are implementing Visual Force pages, so those are specifically designed for Salesforce Classic. So nowadays, we don't use Classic. We prefer Lightning experience. So that's why Lightning components are popular as compared to VF. After understanding the comparison between Lightning and Visual Force, so next feature that Lightning components support, those are events. So if you are implementing Lightning components, so event-driven programming is used in JavaScript and JavaSwing. So in Lightning component, like we are using JavaScript, so these events we can implement there as well. So we need to write handlers that respond to interface events as they occur. There are two types of events in the framework. One is component event and one is application event. So if specifically if I talk about Aura, so these two events are available. So in Aura, basically we create components as well as we create applications. So in later modules, you will see how we can create components and how we can create applications and how they interact with each other. And it can also possible like you have nested components in case of Aura. So that you can reuse particular components, those you have implemented. So if we have two types of implementation, one is component and one is application. So for those two types of events are available. So if you want component event to work, so that has a different functionality. So you can send events from one component to another component so that they can handle. And if you want to perform event on a complete application level, so application events are also available. So a difference between component event and application event, we will understand in the later modules. Now let's talk about browser support. So Aura components support the same browsers as Lightning experience. So if on your browser, you are able to open or you are able to render Lightning experience, then your Aura components will also be supported on that browser. So now I am taking you to Salesforce.org. So I told you two more things in the beginning, that is my domain and developer console. So I'm just opening the setup. So nowadays, if you create any org, so Salesforce automatically enables this my domain for you. So how you can edit that my domain? So earlier we used to create or we used to enable my domain, but now once you create your account in Salesforce. So right now I'm using developer edition. So when I created my account in this developer edition, so this domain is created automatically, right? If this Lightning domain is available, my domain is available, then only you will be able to access Lightning experience, or you will be able to place or create your Aura components. Now, if you want to edit this domain name, so you can modify this and you can check the availability, right? So current my domain URL, so for me, it is sgtech3-ed.mysalesforce.com, right? So this way you can modify this and you can set other settings as well. Next is developer console. So you can open developer console from here, right? So it is already opened in my org. And if you want to create Lightning Aura components, so you need to click on File, New, and here you will see two options are available, Lightning application and Lightning component, right? And if I talk about Lightning web components, so for that, you need to install additional tool or IDE, that is VS Code. And through that VS Code, you will be able to create components, right? So in case of Aura, we will be using developer console only. And while understanding Lightning web components, so we will see how we can create components through VS Code. So in later modules, I will tell you how we can create components and applications with the help of Lightning Aura Component Framework. So in this module, I just explained the basics, or you can say introduction to Lightning component, as well as a little bit about Aura. So thank you.